Hi, I want to talk to prophets today to let you know the anointing that God is placing on you. He's placing a governmental anointing on the prophets. And what is a governmental anointing? That is even what Daniel had. Daniel had the ability to speak to kings. He had the ability to interpret dreams. He had the ability to talk to them and tell them what God wanted for them. Even Nathan the prophet, literally told David, he said, you know, it's you. You were the one that was guilty of things. He literally, God is going to equip us now in this season to be able to go in and speak to people in the government. There's a governmental anointing that God is trying to place on his prophets in this season. Why is God doing that? Because it's time for us to have influence in the government. It's time for us to be able to speak and give direction where you're not just saying, well, this is God saying it, but it will be divinely orchestrated and it will be received. God is trying to keep his people in order. He doesn't want us to go through some of the struggles that we go through. So we need to pray and seek God. If God is placed a governmental anointing on you, how do you know if God has placed an anointing like that on you? Well, you start to have a burden. Not only a burden for praying for the government, but you'll have a burden for people in the government. When I say people in the government, I'm not just talking about the White House. I'm not just talking about Congress. I'm not talking about the mayors and different things like this. I'm talking about administration. Anybody that deals with governmental type work, those are school officials. Those are people that run businesses. That's a government. It's a well-organized entity. And God is trying to get that anointing to rest on his children. And he's placing it on some of us. Some of you don't understand why you're in the positions you're in right now. Why are you working in certain places? Why are you praying for certain cities? Well, maybe God is trying to get you to pray for that city, because he wants you to now meet the mayor or meet whoever is in charge of that particular location. And we're just praying, we're doing the great work of interceding, but God wants us to go beyond interceding. He wants us to have interaction with them. He wants us to be able to go in, and he's literally opening doors. Can I tell you what I did recently? The Lord put someone on my heart from the city of Lansing, Michigan. And literally the Lord told me what was going to happen in that place. And I reach out and find out information. Pray, ask God, why are you doing this? Why did you show me this, Lord? And when he asks you what it is, pray for the location, but then ask God to open a door for you to be able to go to them, or you to be able to give them a word, or you to be able to have some type of governmental influence. God is not just having us to pray for somebody, pray for a location, pray for the school system without trying to put you in the school system. Now, please, let's understand that the anointing of God is more than just for the church building. God is calling us to go out into the marketplace, and the marketplace is the government. Another thing about the governmental anointing, it's not just the government, the national government that we see, as I said, school systems and administrations and the White House, but it's literally the government of God. God is giving us influence. He's already given us influence, but he's trying to get us now to use the influence. He's saying the kingdom come. So if the kingdom's coming, it must be that we have to fight to get the kingdom to come down here on earth. Kingdoms are clashing right now. And because they're clashing, God is raising up prophets that are willing to fight in the spirit to make the kingdom of God come to earth. The word of God tells us that the government is upon the shoulders of Jesus. But guess what? We are his spokespeople. We are his hands. We are his arms. We are his legs. So we need to use the anointing that is upon us for government. Call it into existence. Pray down strongholds for the government. Pray that the kingdom of God now starts to be unleashed on this earth. But that's a governmental anointing. It's where we're calling the kingdom of God to come, the governmental influence of the kingdom to now rest on this earth. I want to encourage you today. Stop being passive. Stop just waiting on something to feel good. If God is calling you to do this, or if you believe that you have a governmental anointing, or you want that anointing. You want to now start to operate in it. I need you to pray. I need you to seek God. I need you to ask God to give you direction and give you influence. He is now giving us influence. So let's put a mandate on the anointing, on this new mantle that God has given you. If he's calling you to intercede, he's also calling you to go further. And so come on, prophets, rise up with me, and let's now take the government by storm. The word of God tells us that there's a battle going on. And see, we must take things by force. So let's take it by force. There's a governmental anointing taking place, and let's take it by force. Pray with me. Believe God for the anointing to rest upon you. Let's take the kingdom by storm. The government needs you. God is ready to use you. Pray for the mantle to rest on you, and it shall be so. God bless you, and I look forward to talking to you again.